Okay, und weiter geht's. Volker hat irgendein Symbol bei seinem Telefon. Volker, hörst du mich? Nein, der Volker hört mich nicht. Der Jan hingegen hört mich schon, denn der hat mich gerade angerufen. Na gut.
Okay, Marina.
Ja, also ich höre es wieder. Bei Marina ist im Moment nichts. Die müsste man noch mal anrufen. Das funktioniert aber aus irgendeinem Grund nicht.
Ich habe mich eben mit ihr unterhalten. Ah, hallo,
Was?
hallo.
Good evening.
I'm so sorry, my internet just went down. So I had to log
Okay.
out, log in. Yes.
You have just said that the Brookings Institution is largely financed by George Soros, and that George Soros is, to be said, a spokesperson of the Rothschild family, and that the Rothschilds are connected to central banks.
The Rothschild have all the central banks of the world. They own them.
Okay. Also George Soros, der bekannte Milliardär, soll, man sagt ihm nach, er sei Sprecher von der Familie Rothschild. Und dann die Rothschild sagt man nach, dass sie die Zentralbanken haben. Are not most of the central banks in the property of the countries?
No, the central people don't understand this. Every central bank in every country is a private company. It's not owned by the state. It's a private company. And it's they're all owned from the Rothschild family.
That's I've read heard the same for the first time from activist from Syria. She's calling herself Syrian girl and also criticizing the Rothschild family. But if I look, for example, at the Federal Reserve Bank website, they claim that today the shareholders of the regional Feds, and the regional Feds they are shareholders, as I think, as Federal Reserve, at the federal level, the regional shareholders are the bigger banks in the USA, not necessarily the original founders of the Fed. And I've not found the name of Rothschild. They are just one of the biggest examples.
Yes, that is what they want people to believe, but it's not activists who say this. This is how it is because all the money of the world, the biggest gold reserves, are owned by the Rothschild family. In fact, some people say, and I don't know if this is true because I've never conducted my own investigation. I only know what the various documentaries and news reports say. All the most of the gold in the world is owned by the Rothschild family. And the Rothschild family controls all the central banks of the world. The only countries that do not have a Rothschild central bank are Venezuela, Iran, and I'm not sure about Syria.
I think Syria also not.
Yeah, and up until the war in Libya, Libya did not have either. Now Libya has a central bank. So now you know why the war happened in Libya.
Okay. I think we would like to pick up this issue in a later in another radio show to understand better. I must confess I'm a bit confused. For example, if I look at the Federal Reserve in the USA, this is indirectly privately owned because it belongs to the 12 regional Federal Reserve banks, and they are owned by private banks, and it seems even not by the original ones who have initiated the Fed, like it's not only a JP Morgan Chase Bank, for example, but also banks which had in the beginning nothing to do with this Fed system. But I would like to come to the Brookings Institution. I think it's not the only think tank where Mr. Soros has a large influence. I've read in the Hintergrund magazine, it's also European Council on Foreign Relations, and also he has his own big NGO, Open Society Institute, gives large donations to Human Rights Watch.
Well, I'll tell you what he does at the Brookings Institute. The
Okay.
Brookings Institute with Soros, because okay, Soros doesn't come out and say hello, I give money to the Brookings Institute. Okay. He has NGOs that do that, non-governmental organizations. Okay. So the Brookings Institute is an organization that has been involved with many international state-sponsored programs, okay? And hold on. And one that they want to make a United Nations One World Government, okay? Like, for instance, the Bilderbergers want to do something similar. The United Nations wants to do something similar. United States and England want to do something similar. Okay? These are all very rich, 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 rich men who are very, very powerful, and they want to make a one world government. So the Brookings Institute, okay, or the members of the Brookings Institute, they usually promote global collaboration, okay, on banking. That's why Mr. Soros is very, very rich, okay, and along with banking trade also, okay, they want to expand the Kyoto Protocol, okay. And they want to nationalize health insurance for children. So,
Okay.
yeah.
I'm
Maybe you want to explain this?
late. Okay. Ja, ich hatte nochmal nachgefragt wegen Zentralbanken und Rothschild. Es gibt halt verschiedene Quellen, die sagen, dass die Rothschilds den meisten Zentralbanken außer in Syrien, Iran und Venezuela gehören. Da habe ich Zweifel eben dran geäußert, weil die Federal Reserve Bankensystem der USA, das gehört, so die US-Bundesbank, Federal Reserve, gehört den 12 regionalen Landeszentralbanken, die auch Federal Reserve heißen, und an denen wiederum sind größere Banken in den USA beteiligt, und das nicht unbedingt nur die größeren Banken, die schon dabei waren, als das System gegründet wurde. So stellt sich zumindest nach außen dar. Würden das gerne in einer anderen Sendung wieder auch genauer aufgreifen, das Thema. Ja, Herr Soros, ist ja nicht nur dann beim Brookings Institute, bei der Brookings Institution, sondern er hat seine eigene Stiftung, Open Society Stiftung für offene Gesellschaft, dann European Council on Foreign Relations, laut der Zeitung Hintergrund ist er der größte von den Finanziers, und Human Rights Watch gehört zum Beispiel auch zu den NGOs, wo er mal größeren Betrag gespendet hat, bekannte Menschenrechtsorganisation. Ja, Marina Spanos sagt, er spendet nicht direkt an Brookings, sondern auch mit Hilfe von NGOs. Und Brookings Institution beschäftigt sich mit vielen ja, aus öffentlichen Geldern finanzierten Programmen. Sie beschäftigen sich mit Banken, beschäftigen sich mit Handel. Sie wollen eine Stärkung des Kyoto-Protokolls, und sie wollen staatliche Krankenversicherung für Kinder. I've got a question from understanding. I have had the idea that these big think tanks are rather very neoliberal, and now there's a Brookings Institution and supported with by this billionaire Mr. Soros, and they stand up for public health insurance for children. Does this match together? I'm really confused.
Yeah.
Is this a positive face of them?
Well, listen, George Soros is a very, I think he's even worse than Henry Kissinger, okay? Because George Soros, first of all, you know, he's a former Jewish German. German Jewish from Hungary. I'm sorry. Who hates Jewish people. He hates Jewish people, okay? So this is a man full of contradictions. He has too many contradictions in his character. Throughout his life, he was like that. And his only passion is to make money. That's why he has billions and billions and billions of dollars, okay? He influences a lot of NGOs with very, very nice names. The ones that you just said, with how you explained the Open Society Foundation, okay, sounds very nice. But do you know that the Open Society Foundation has caused a lot of controversy in the Balkan region? In, for instance, they want to change borders. They want to make one country into five countries. They want to, I don't know, they want to make Fyrom, okay? And maybe Thessalonica, which is the second largest city in Greece, into one country, okay? These are very rich and powerful men who sit down at a table and say, okay, if this country does not do that, then we either take them to war, we either destroy their banks, we either do this or we either do that. Just like the other think tanks are, they're even worse. And the Brookings Institute, just like Columbia University, okay, in the United States, is a place where all these men are trained, who go on to the Brookings Institute and then to other organizations like the Bilderberg and whatever. And if you look at the members of the Brookings Institute, all these members are on the Fed, they're on the Trilateral Commission. They're on all the, you know, in the build. They're Bilderbergers, okay? These are very, very, very bad, very, very bad people.
Okay. Ich hatte gefragt bei Brookings Institution, dass ich es erstaunlich finde, dass sie sich für staatlich finanzierte Krankenversicherung für Kinder einsetzen. Das klingt ja sehr positiv. Und dass aber ich habe so die Vorstellung hatte, dass diese großen Thinktanks oft eher sehr neoliberale Ziele verfolgen. Und da Marinas Banos mir erklärt, der Charakter auch von Herrn Soros, dass Herr Soros, er kommt aus Ungarn, ist eigentlich jüdischen Ursprungs und ist aber selber jüdischen Bevölkerung gegenüber eher unfreundlich eingestellt, also dass er ein Mann mit lauter Widersprüchen ist, dass er eben sehr nach Geld strebt. Und seine Stiftung Open Society Foundation auch darüber nachdenkt, zum Beispiel Grenzen zwischen Staaten zu verschieben, aus einem Staat mehrere Staaten zu machen, solche Pläne diskutiert. Und dass da eben auch Gefahren bestehen für Staaten, wenn sie sich nicht so verhalten, wie solche Denkfabriken es wollen. Dann ist sie zurückgekommen auf die, und dass deswegen die Open Society Foundation von Herrn Soros sehr kritisch gesehen wird in manchen Orten im Balkan. Da ist sie zurückgekommen zum Brookings Institution. Die Mitglieder dort findet man auch bei der, so große Banken, die auch von der US-Notenbank Fed beteiligt sind. Trilaterale, auch Bilderberger findet man dort. You have mentioned on Hellas Frappé that a recommendations which the Brookings Institution has made for Syria. They have
Yes.
recommended how Turkey and how Israel should behave regarding Syria. Does this institution, it's an US institution, not a Turkish or Israeli one, does it have influence there?
Yes, of course. The Brookings Institute, this in 19 in 2008, sorry, in 2009, published a document called "Which Path to Persia?" Okay, the document "Which Path to Persia?" In other words, this whole document is a manual. It's a guide how to make war with all the Middle East. Okay. This document is public knowledge now, okay? So this was written in 2009 by the Brookings Institute as a blueprint for confronting Iran, because this is the goal. It's the West wants it's the oil in Iran, okay? But to get to Iran, they have to weaken all the other countries that support Iran. Syria is one of those countries. Okay? Plus, they want to weaken, plus, they also want Syria because they do not want a Russian presence in the Mediterranean. And Russia has a very large naval base, military base in Tartus, in Syria. So they don't want this. Plus the West, and when I say the West, it's not just the Brookings Institute. It's the whole West, even Europe, okay? Even the United States, even Europe, all of the West does not want Iran to build any pipelines. This is very important that you translate this into German. Any pipelines that are coming from Iran, and instead the West is promoting the TAP pipeline from Azerbaijan. Okay? That's why we see all these wars now, all the Chechen and the bad guys and the all these terrorists and all this stuff, And I think I sent you the information, which you can translate to your readers, which says specifically that in 2009, okay, the Brookings Institute had already planned to invade Syria.
Ah, okay, also es gibt eine,
Well, oh, by the way, I'm sorry, I forgot
okay.
to mention this. With leaders from, check this out. Goldman Sachs, the Carlyle Group bombed Iraq. This is the company of, if I'm not mistaken, of George Bush. They bombed Iraq. They made the most money from Iraq. They bombed Iraq, and now the Iraqi people are paying them.
Hello?
Okay, can you hear me now?
Yes, we are now connected with Jan again. Thank you. Okay, I translate. Ja, also die Brookings Institution hat 2009 eine Broschüre herausgebracht. Sie haben einen Plan veröffentlicht, das hieß Which Paths to Persia? Und darf ich nochmal sehen? Da ging es darum, wie man sich gegen Iran wenden kann. Und in 2009 hat Brookings Institution eine Broschüre rausgebracht, Formation, das haben sie genannt, Path to Persia. Es geht darum, sich gegen den Iran zu wenden. Und das ist wie eine Blaupause dafür. Und Marina Svanos hat gesagt, dass wenn man sich heute gegen Syrien wendet, das eben auch ein Grund sein kann, weil Syrien eben mit dem Iran verbündet ist. Man wendet sich aber vielleicht auch gegen Syrien, weil es einem nicht gefällt, dass die Russen eine Marinebasis haben fürs Mittelmeer. Brookings Institution ist noch nicht der einzige Think Tank, der in dieser Richtung denkt. Es gibt bei diesem Bridge Pass zu Persia gibt es als Vorwort ist ein Vorwort drin von Andy Smith Richardson Foundation, wo Zbigniew Brzezinski einer Acting Governor ist. Ich verstehe es so im Vorstand. Sie hat schriftlich Informationen gegeben, diese Smith Richardson Foundation finanziert eine Menge von globalistischen Projekten wie Studien zu Geoengineering, Nation Building, also Staaten, die erst zerstört worden sind, wieder neu aufzubauen. Dann beschäftigen die sich mit der Kaukasusregion und Studien, auch in Studien 2009 über Methoden zu entwickeln für die Unterstützung politischer Übergangsbewegungen in Polen, Ägypten, Nepal, Haiti, Vietnam, Kambodscha, Simbabwe und Burma. Auch erwähnt wird, wenn ich es richtig verstehe, Pass of Persia, die Crown Family Foundation aus Chicago. Also es scheint verschiedene Thinktanks, Denkfabriken zu sein, die Pläne dafür entwerfen, die möglicherweise von der Politik aufgegriffen werden, wie man Einfluss in verschiedensten Ländern nimmt. Die Brookings Institution selbst ist geschaffen worden, Moment, von verschiedenen globalistischen Organisationen finanziert. Also nicht nur Soros, Carnegie Corporation, Rockefeller Foundation, Ford Foundation. Brookings bekommt
Probably Pepsi and Coca-Cola too.
Brookings bekommt Spenden von großen US-Konzernen wie Goldman Sachs, wie Rüstungskonzern Carlyle Group, von der Versicherungswirtschaft, von Pepsi, von Alcoa. Und verschiedenen Pepsi und Alcoa sind Konzerne, die beim Council on Foreign Relations involviert sind und auch andere Konzerne, die beim Council on Foreign Relations sind, zum Beispiel McKinsey und Company. The membership of several of the big think tanks in the USA, often have partly the same members.
Well, most of the members of the Brookings Institute are really the members of the biggest banks in the world, okay? And the biggest defense contractors in the world.
Okay, also zu den größten, wichtigsten Mitgliedern von Brookings Institut dazu gehören einige der größten Banken der Welt, aber auch eine der größten Verteidigungsdienstleister. Defense Contractor, you mean mercenary firms?
Can you repeat the question? I didn't
Do
hear
you
that.
mean defense contractors, mercenary firms?
Oh, defense contractors, meaning people who build submarines, guns,
Ah,
you
not.
know?
I understand who.
These are defense contractors. Bombs.
Production for armament, not.
Yes. In English, we say defense contractors.
Okay. You have on Hellas Frappe referred to recommendations which the Brookings Institution has made for Syria and what they think, what the Brookings Institution says, what Turkey and Israel should do. What have they recommended for Syria?
Okay, as I said before, I gave you a little bit of background why, and I spoke about Soros because I was very specific when I said that there's specific countries in the world where there are no central banks that are owned by the Rothschild family. Okay, so this is one of the reasons they make the Arab Spring. Okay, because the goal was to make a central bank in Libya, and the goal was to control the oil. Now, at the moment in the world, okay, these very rich men, okay, control about 70% of the world's oil. The only big piece of oil left, the really big, second biggest reserves, are in Iran. And this is why they want to attack Iran. But as I said before, the only way to attack Iran is to at first attack it's the people who support Iran. For example, Syria, Lebanon, Libya. So they attacked Libya and they took the oil from Libya. And Iraq. They attacked Iraq and they took the oil of Iraq. Then they attacked Libya. They took the oil of Libya. Now they want to attack Syria for the same reason. But Syria, here is the difference. It's not about the natural gas or the oil only. And it's not only because they want to weaken Iran, okay? It's also because they want to weaken Russia and China, okay? The biggest enemy for the West is China and Russia, but mostly China, because in maybe by 2020, 2025, I am not very sure, China will be the number one economy on the planet. And China has a lot of gold. And China can decide that, hey, I want to back my, I don't know what their money is called, the Chinese money with gold. I don't want to back it with the system that it is today. The system that it is today can just create that money out of nothing, out of air. You understand? So if they decide to back it with gold, then people are going to have a lot of countries are going to have problems. And I think this is probably the reason Germany asked for its gold back from the U United States. I think last month or the month before, the gold from Germany, the German government asked for its gold back because it was in New York, Germany's gold.
Like to translate.
Yes.
Ja, ich hatte gefragt, was der Brookings Institution empfiehlt, was die Türkei und Israel aus Sicht der Brookings Institution bezüglich Syrien tun sollen. Und ja, es geht darum, dass reiche Leute, mächtige Leute aus dem Westen, vielleicht 70% des weltweiten Öls inzwischen unter ihrer Kontrolle haben, aber 30% ist halt nicht unter westlicher Kontrolle und davon wiederum ist eben ein erheblicher Prozentsatz im Iran und immer wieder anti-iranischen Vorstöße, ein Grund dafür dürfte auch sein, das Öl kontrollieren zu wollen. Und man wendet sich eben auch gegen Länder, die mit dem Iran ein gutes Verhältnis haben. Man hat auch wegen des Öls hat man erst den Irak angegriffen, dann hat da seine Ölverträge sich gesichert. Dann kam später der arabische Frühling. Beim arabischen Frühling hat man die Situation genutzt, um in Libyen Gaddafi zu stürzen, dass das Öl dann unter westliche Kontrolle kommt. Und Ja, mit Syrien, es wird wahrscheinlich nicht nur Syrien sein, was man destabilisieren wird. Libanon stellt sich die gleiche Frage. Und bei Syrien kommt aber hinzu, es ist nicht nur wegen Iran, sondern es geht auch um Russland, es geht auch um China, die man als Konkurrenten schwächen will. 2020 bis 2025 könnte China zur größten Wirtschaftsmacht der Welt werden. Und wenn China zum Beispiel jetzt seine Währung, weil China auch einige an Goldreserven hat, mit Gold unterlegen würde, dann werden wahrscheinlich viele Leute dann die chinesische Währung haben wollen. Und Länder, die heute im heutigen Geldsystem im Riesengeldmengen sozusagen aus Luft schöpfen, die hätten dann mit ihrer Währung ein Problem. Deutschland zum Beispiel scheint auch wieder stark auf Gold zu setzen. Die deutsche Regierung hat vor 1 oder 2 Monaten ihr Gold zurückhaben wollen, was wohl in den USA, in New York aufbewahrt wird. You have said on your blog that also Greek politicians come to the Brookings Institution. Can you tell me some names and do you know anything about the connection? What are Greek
Very
politicians
good
doing here?
question. Very good question. Okay. It's very funny that only George Papandreou, he did not speak at the Brookings Institute, but because when he was Prime Minister of Greece, there was many reports about his friendship with George Soros. Okay? So then we saw George Papandreou leave Greece and go to the United States and teach at Columbia University. Okay, that's not a coincidence. You know, when you scratch George Soros's back, he scratches your back. Then when they this institute, this think tank, because it's not only the Brookings, it's many think tanks, okay? There's Stratfor, there's many think tanks like that. When this specific institute wanted to put its foot again in Greece, influence developments in Greece, okay? It invited Alexis Tsipras to speak at the institute. And it has also invited Evangelos Venizelos to speak there. Okay? And it's the coincidence is that all these leaders are either leftists or from the socialist side. Because the Brookings Institute only supports socialist leaders. And the sad part is that they go there and they make very nice speeches, but the people that they are speaking to are murderers because they play on the markets. For instance, George Soros made a lot of money from the crisis in the Eurozone, a lot of money. Okay? They go to countries like Afghanistan or Iraq, and they write up a report how to invade this country. And the people who are members of this institute make money from this country by bombing it. So just the fact that the Greek politicians went there to speak, okay, is insulting. It's insulting to the Greek people because the Greek people, yes, we are European, but because we are very close to the Middle East, we always had very, very good relations with the Arab world. Always. Very good relations. And we have to keep a very nice balance. But today's socialists, okay, are not the socialists, for instance, of the World Socialist Organization. Mr. Papandreou is not the president of the World Socialist Organization. He's the president, now listen to this carefully, of the Socialist International Organization. It's two different organizations. And these organizations have two completely different agendas. You cannot be a socialist and take a limousine and drink champagne and eat caviar, okay? When you're a socialist, you're an activist, and you go down on the streets and you fight for human rights and blah, 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 blah. Mr. Papandreou is not a socialist. Mr. Papandreou is 1,000,000% capitalist, just like Mr. Tsipras is and just like Mr. Venizelos is. They sell socialism because it's an ideology, but when you speak at an institute like Brookings, where you know that people are making multi-million dollars from making wars, you're not selling peace and you're not talking about feeding the poor. You're talking about feeding more money to rich people.
One moment. The Brookings Institution, why does it reach socialists and leftist people if the membership of this institution does not differ so much from other think tanks which are more obvious to the right side?
I will explain. This is an American idea, okay? Americans are super, super people, but they are victims. And they are victims of a system that has casino politics, okay? This is what the economy of the United States is. It's a casino economy. Very, very rich and very, very poor. Because people are afraid, the 1% is very afraid of the 99%, okay? And because they're afraid, they have to talk a little bit socialism. And they have to talk a little bit, human rights, a little bit, okay? But the real agenda is the same, like the capitalists. It's exactly the same. So they pretend, they play theater that they are socialists, like Mr. Papandreou, Mr. Tsipras, Mr. Venizelos. These are not socialists. I do not know why they call each other socialists. I explained to you cannot drink champagne and eat caviar and say you are a socialist. This is crazy. Okay? You a socialist is someone who believes in equality. That's why there's a war between the Socialist International, which Mr. Papandreou, Mr. Tsipras, Mr. Venizelos is from, and the other organization, the Socialist World Organization. And you can don't have to take my opinion. If you do your own research, go on to the internet, type in these addresses, World Socialist Organization and International Socialist. It's two different organizations. The International Socialist Organization is sponsored all by Soros.
Okay.
Now you understand how it... Yeah, how it's all together?
The Brookings Institution sieht mehr, zumindest was Griechenland angeht, mehr linke Politiker an. Ob es nun Sozialisten sind wie Papandreou oder Venizelos oder Politiker weiter links wie Tsipras, und hat eher gibt sich ein Gesicht. Die reden ein wenig mit nach Sozialismus, sie reden ein wenig nach Menschenrechten. Marina Spanos Gibt es eben verschiedene internationale Bündnisse von Sozialisten, Sozialistische Internationale, Socialist International, und da soll eben auch Soros starken Einfluss haben, Socialist World Organization hingegen nicht, und das sind eben zwei große sozialistische Bündnisse und Politiker, die sich Sozialisten nennen und selber Kaviar essen, Champagner trinken, das sind vielleicht auch nicht unbedingt wirklich so echte Sozialisten. Okay.
I know it's a lot to explain, and I'm very sorry, but a lot of people don't understand the difference, you know.
I'm still not sure if Alexis Tsipras, if they will really draw him over the table, because Syriza has been the composition of 5 or 6 left-wing parties which have joined together, and so it seems that there are many interests in this party, and that it's not so easy for one person, if they just change the leader of Syriza, then to change the course of the whole party. That's not so easy for me.
Okay, I'll explain something. Alexis Tsipras, okay, is a ambitious young man, okay? He's only 40 years old, 39. He has big dreams to be a politician, bigger politician, prime minister maybe, okay? So I don't know if he had financial support, but I know he had a lot of support from people like Yana Angelopoulou, who is very good friends with the Clintons. Okay? Very, very, very good friends with the Clintons. And whenever you hear the name Clinton family, you know it's George Soros is there. Okay? Trust me when I say this. So she's very good friends. Now, so did George Papandreou. That's why when George Papandreou left Greece, before going to Columbia University, he taught at Kennedy School at Harvard University for maybe 3 months. In a department that was financially supported by Yana Angelopoulou. Okay? So all of these people are tied together. One helps the other. Okay? Alexis Tsipras wants the opportunity. And he made a very big mistake. He accepted their help, probably, because there's a lot of talk in Athens that a big team from Yana Angelopoulou came to Greece and was helping him with his public image. Okay? And this is right a little bit right before the Brookings Institute. But when he went to the United States, okay, the people at the Brookings Institute listened to him, but they were not very happy with him. Not because they didn't like him, but because they do not believe that he has the capability to be a leader. So now they changed the agenda again. And I'll tell you after what they're doing now. But at Tsipras, because he wants to be prime minister, now he's doing everything that everybody wants, all these people want. Okay? Haven't you noticed that now Tsipras is not talking about destroying the memorandums? He doesn't say this anymore. He stopped saying this. And people in this party in Syriza that were saying this, stop saying this too. Now they said, we will be very okay with the creditors, with IMF, with ECB, with European... the same thing that the government says. Okay? That's why I told you, these are not socialists. Socialists are completely, it's a completely different organization. And I'm going to tell you something else. At the recent Socialist International Conference in I think this was in Portugal, 2 months ago, okay? Do you know that the president of the Youth Socialist International, a young girl, I think she was from Brazil, I'm not sure, okay? I think she was Spanish or from some Latin American country, I think she was. She got up and she actually really let Mr. Papandreou have it. She said everything that she said about him was terrible because he's the president of the socialist movement. She says, how can we be socialists and we ride in limousines?
Okay.
Now you understand the difference?
Yes. Okay, Alexis Tsipras hat Verbindung zu, can you tell me the name, Aman Gelopoulou?
Yana Gelopoulou, some people might remember her for organizing the 2004 Olympic Games.
Okay, and she has supported his study for 3 months at the Kennedy School at Harvard?
No, she's very rich. Okay, she apparently is financially supports the Kennedy School, a department in the Kennedy School.
Okay.
Sorry, excuse me. A department, this is very important. You have to say this to your listeners. A department which discusses the crisis in Europe.
Okay.
Very important.
Yana Evangelopoulou. Yana Angelopoulou, okay. Yanga Angelopoulou ist eine sehr reiche Frau in Griechenland und die finanziert eine Abteilung der in der Kennedy School an der Harvard Universität, also Einrichtung an der Harvard Universität, die sich wiederum beschäftigen mit der Krise in Europa. Und Alexis Tsipras hat in der Kennedy School in Harvard 3 Monate verbracht. Da könnte also ein gewisser Einfluss sein. Gleichzeitig hat diese Yana Angelopoulou gute Kontakte mit den Clintons und die wiederum gute Kontakte mit George Soros. Also da könnte darüber ein indirekter Einfluss bestehen. Bei der Brookings Institution, wo Tsipras gesprochen hat, scheint man zwar mit dem, was er gesagt hat, zufrieden zu sein, aber Zweifel zu haben, ob er wirklich die Fähigkeiten hat, ein griechischer Premierminister zu sein. Interessant ist, Syriza soll seine Kritik gegenüber den Sparauflagen gegen Griechenland zurückgefahren haben. Nicht nur Tsipras alleine. Könnte also ein gewisser Einfluss sein. Bei der vor 2 Monaten ungefähr in Portugal-Konferenz der Sozialistischen Internationale hat eine Frau von der Jugendorganisation aus Brasilien, Spanisch, ich glaube Brasilien, die auch die Frage gestellt, ob es denn sein kann, dass Leute, sozialistische Politiker, einen teuren Lebenswandel haben. Okay.
I will give you another, one more example. You know the site from Mr. Global Research, right? From Mr. Shadowsky, I'm not sure if I said his name right. Michael Shadowsky?
Yes.
Yeah. He supports the World Socialist Organization. That's
not
what
the
I understand.
Not the Socialist International.
No.
Okay.
It's two. This is what I'm trying to explain to you. It's two different organizations.
Okay.
It's not social. They use the name socialist, but the Socialist World and the Socialist International are two different organizations. Now, I wanted to say something about Tsipras. Okay? Tsipras, right now there's a very big war in PASOK in Greece between Mr. Venizelos, people who support Venizelos, and people who still support, believe it or not, Papandreou. Okay? And Tsipras, because he's, I told you, he wants power, he's not attacking. This is a tactic, okay? It's a strategy. He's not attacking George Papandreou, and he's only attacking Venizelos. And Tsipras is doing this because he wants the votes of George Papandreou. But remember before, maybe you should explain that because I have something to tell you after that. Maybe you should explain that.
Okay, ich habe es eben falsch verstanden. George Soros unterstützt nicht die Sozialistische Internationale, sondern die World Socialist Organization. Dann in der PASOK-Partei gibt es einen Machtkampf zwischen Unterstützern von Papandreou und von Venizelos. Und Alexis Tsipras als Vorsitzender der Syriza-Partei politisch eben nur Venizelos an und schon Papandreou und scheint auf die Stimmen von Papandreou, die Papandreou sonst bekommt, darauf zu schielen.
Okay, remember before I mentioned Yana Angelopoulou, okay?
Okay, yes.
You have to remember this name because you are going to see a lot of news about her from now on. Because Yana Angelopoulou is a very, very, very good friend of the Hillary Clinton, okay? Yes. And whoever's a friend of Hillary Clinton is a friend of George Soros. Okay? Yes. And now, because Tsipras is no good for them, that's why they invited him to the Brookings Institute, okay? To see, is he good? Is he not good? They didn't like him. So now, Yana Angelopoulou and George Papandreou are going to make a new party, a new political party called the Democrats. Just like the American Democrats, and it's going to be the same policies like Obama's party, Hillary's party, just like the Democrats in the US. And she's coming to Greece, and she's doing this to attack mostly Germany, mostly Germany.
In den, also in den USA gibt es jetzt zurzeit die Frau Angelopoulou. Und der Herr Papandreou, die denken darüber nach, eine neue Partei zu machen, die Demokraten nach dem US-Vorbild. Und die Frau Angelopoulou tut das, weil sie gegen Deutschland sei. Why is this an attack against Germany?
Because Mrs. Merkel may be a very tough lady, but I know that the majority of the German people still want her as leader of Germany. Okay? So she will be the next leader. But because the people who are behind Mrs. Angelopoulou want to hurt the euro, they do not want a strong euro, okay? They will start attacking Germany. It's that simple. Because she's Mrs. Angelopoulou's very she has the network behind her. She has all the strongest, most richest people in the world. Even the Queen she has behind her.
Ah,
The Queen of England.
I
Yes.
understand. Okay, es ist also nicht, dass die Frau Angelopoulou mit dieser Partei jetzt gegen Deutschland wäre, sondern es scheint so zu sein, dass reiche Leute, mit denen sie eben auch verbunden sind, sich nun gegen Deutschland wenden wollen. It seems to me now, when they think that all their bankers' enrichment mechanisms in the name of safeguarding the euro are through, and that the German votes are not needed anymore. Now they can destroy also Germany.
Of course, because this was the first war was about the dollar against the euro. Because, for instance, I give you one example. For instance, Saddam Hussein suddenly started buying euros instead of dollars.
Okay.
Other maybe Iran might buy euros. Or maybe Iran will start to trade its oil in euros and not in dollars. This is what it's all about. That's why the central banks of the world control all the oil. You understand? So it can only be traded in dollars, not in any other currency.
Die Leute, mit denen die Frau Angelopoulou zusammenhängt, also Hillary Clinton, George Soros, auch die Königin von England, die scheinen alle das Interesse zu haben, den Euro zu schwächen. Und dass der Dollar entsprechend stärker wird im Vergleich zum Euro. Und ja, da hab ich doch die Frage eingeworfen, jetzt wo man die ganzen Banker-Bereicherungsmechanismen hat im Namen der Rettung des Euro, die deutschen Stimmen jetzt nicht mehr braucht, ob man jetzt eben auch die deutsche Wirtschaft ins Visier nimmt. Und Einschätzung teilt Marinas Banos auch. Ja, und zum Beispiel Saddam Hussein wollte Öl in Euro verkaufen. Und das scheinen eben bestimmte reiche Leute nicht dulden zu wollen, dass der Euro zu stark wird im Vergleich zum Dollar. Vor allem nicht zu wollen, dass wichtige Güter wie Öl in Euro gehandelt werden. We have a question from our listeners. If the German government now has called the U.S. government to the U.S. central bank to send back the German gold, what do you think? Will Germany get the gold back, or might it have been stolen by the central bank system?
Well, when remember Strauss-Kahn, the before Christine Lagarde at the IMF. Okay, remember the scandal with Strauss-Kahn? They said that the real story behind the scandal, which is, we all know it's not the real story, is not because Sarkozy was afraid of the competition. It's because, I don't know if this is true, some reports said this. They said that it's because Strauss-Kahn discovered that there was no gold at the Federal Reserve. Okay? Now, I don't know if this is true. These are stories that were circulating in the internet. As for Germany, if it is true, then, Germany's going to have a problem. But I do know that Germany filed a formal request to return the gold to Germany, because it's gold. Not, I don't know if it's all of its gold or half of its gold. I really don't know, but I know that they did put this request in at the Federal Reserve, and this happened 2 months ago. You can check with the German government. I'm sure you'll find the announcement somewhere.
Okay. I would like to. Okay, sorry. Ja, es gibt eben verschiedene Gerüchte im Internet, dass eben die Fed auch vielleicht überhaupt kein Gold aufbewahrt habe. Und ja, nun, wenn Deutschland jetzt das Gold zurückhaben möchte, wird man sicherlich die öffentliche Ankündigung finden, dass Deutschland das offiziell verlautbares Gold zurückhaben will und ob Deutschland das Gold dann hinterher auch zurückbekommen hat. Okay. Well, We have looked at several issues starting from the Brookings Institution. Many thanks for the interview.
You're very, very welcome. And I just wanted your listeners to understand how the Brookings, Soros, Papandreou, the Democrats in the United States, which say they are socialists, but you know they're not socialists, they're very rich. Okay? All these things are tied together, and that this is nothing against the World Socialist Organization, which is a different organization than the World Socialist, than the Socialist International. One is the World Socialist Organization, the other one is called Socialist International. The Socialist International Organization is dangerous. It's the organization that the president is Papandreou. Papandreou is tied to Angelopoulou. Angelopoulou is tied to the Clintons. The Clintons are tied to George Soros. George Soros is the front man for the Rothschild. So now you understand the connection, okay? And all these people are tied to the Brookings Institute. They're tied to the Bilderberg meetings. They're tied to many similar think tanks. It's not just the Brookings Institute. If we decide to do another show like this again on your radio station, I will give you another list with so many other institutes like this.
Okay. Ja, es ist wichtig, da einen Bogen zu spannen von den Leuten, also zum Beispiel Andreas Papandreou als Chef der Sozialistischen Internationale und wer mit wem dort zusammenhängt. Und auch diese Demokraten, die sagen, sie seien sozialistisch, aber wenn man schaut, mit wem sie zusammenarbeiten, dann kommt man da zu anderen Ergebnissen. Ja, many thanks for the interview, and we're looking forward to have you in the internet radio show again, and we wish the very, 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 very best to the person who has the emergency, and that he becomes healthy again.
Thank you. Thank you very, very much. And I hope your readers log on to my blog, elasfrappe.blogspot.com. And they can read, I post stories like this every day. They can read them if they're in the English language, so they can read them every day. I try to say the truth to people as much as I can, and they can read them. And thank you. Have a wonderful night. Good night, Germany. Good night.
Good night, Therese. The very best wishes. Ja, hier ist nochmal Volker Reusing. Das war heute eine spannende, wechselhafte Sendung und es ist klasse, dass Marina Spanos sich noch die Zeit genommen hat, dass wir Freeman erreicht haben. Ja, nächste Sendetermin regulär wäre wieder in 2 Wochen, aber wir werden dann, wenn technisch alles gut geht, werden wir von der Bilderberg-Konferenz berichten. Diese Woche Samstag, Sonntag schauen wir, wie es technisch klappt. Und das heißt, man wird also auch in den nächsten Tagen noch von uns hören. Mehr mag ich an dieser Stelle noch nicht verraten, wünsche Ihnen einen guten Abend und schauen Sie auf die Webseite von www.jungledrum.de und dort werden Sie dann die nächsten Sendungen auch diese Woche angekündigt finden. Herzlichen Dank und noch einen guten Abend.